Let me tell you why you're here. You're here because you have a question. It's there, like a splinter in your mind. The Matrix, like the Apple Watch, is full of deja vu, but thanks to Evidence Scientific, we've got great views of this year's tech. However, we do have questions. Why didn't these Apple Watches launch with double tap anyway? At least this double tap won't fail us. The Apple Watch Ultra 2 may not be sporting the rumored micro-LED screens, but it is nice to see those itty-bitty pixels up close. Want to see through them? Creative Electron can do that too. First order of business, those external screws. I know, we probably won't get anywhere, but a teardownist can hope. I'm also hoping to see some kind of sensor for the new double tap tech. Alas, it looks the same as last year. No visible light sensor or strain gauge. It's probably just a microscopic accelerometer somewhere. Time to go back to the beginning. We've perfected our Apple Watch Ultra display removal technique since the Ultra's debut. Get a grip of the vise, heat, and gently lever. Works like a charm. The battery needs to come out before we can get to the screen, and it's definitely not easy. These screws are tiny compared to this basmati rice. Plus, this bracket hole is much too small for even our precision long-necked bits. But we managed to get it out, and hey, it's still got the little expansion cut out. No, that's not a hair. And it's got a hard shell. While it looks identical to last year's, this battery has a new model number and measures in at a slightly higher 2.18 watt-hours. Now we've got screen, sapphire glass and all. What say we give this a scratch under our snazzy new microscope? It took about an 8 on the Mohs hardness scale to scratch it, which is about on par for sapphire. That said, these are ultra-fine scratches that you can barely see. All that's left is the Taptic engine. Hefty, but the same weight as last year. And finally, oodles of screws later, the SIP is free. The Ultra is all tapped out. As for the Series 9, these x-ray previews of the 45mm watch show some familiar features, and I don't see a hard shell battery either. But this year, we're looking for double tap tech in the 41mm watch. It just fits me better. Oh, and we took a peek at the new fine woven fabric, too. You can see there's a bit of marring from the buckle already. Check the site for an in-depth review on this somewhat delicate leather replacement. Also, I don't love this buckle. Give it the clamps, some heat, and open sesame. We couldn't disconnect the screen here, but to be safe, I'm gonna pop the battery out, as annoying as that is. The hard shell on this makes prying feel a lot less terrifying, but this glue is stubborn. It really feels like I'm gonna break something. All's well that ends well for this pint-sized 1.09 watt-hour battery. Now I've got screen access, and I won't fry the display when I disconnect it. All I have to do is peel up. Ugh, I thought this would be the easiest way to remove the tape, but it's really no fun. Okay, let's speed run the rear sensor. A few screws and bye-bye Taptic engine. Easy prying thanks to that nice goop-free adhesive, and the panel is free, revealing pretty much the same stuff as ever. The only change I see appears to be a nice spongy ring of foam, rather than the individual pieces found in other models. Given everything else is the same, I'm gonna assume this is some kind of fancy cushioning tap foam. We did it, guys. We found the double tap feature. In all seriousness, the Apple Watch is loads nicer than it used to be, particularly on the adhesive and cable management fronts. But this year's big feature is double tap, something that duplicates existing accessibility features, isn't available at launch, and doesn't require any fancy new hardware. Maybe we don't need yearly upgrades for the Apple Watch. Unless you want a tutorial for Vision Pro?